Hey, this is Avas Kashyap, and I've studied my engineering. I've done my engineering from from electrical and electronics, and right now I'm working as a trainee decision scientist in DC.
So, Avas, can you describe to us Mu Sigma in a few words? What is the company all about?
So, basically, if you talk about in the terms of basically, if you see the website, it's a Mu Sigma analytics company. But again, we should not just confuse ourselves that it is only into analytics. So it deals with a lot of things, like I've explained in the previous examples, like it's giving exposure and all those things. Basically, if it's a one-line thing, then Mu Sigma is a basically analytics company.
And so, what is the client reach like? Where all do we find clients? Do we have any clients in India?
For the projects I've worked in and I've heard from my batchmates or from my friends, we don't generally have a base in India. Like, we have clients more from, I think the maximum market for Mu Sigma is in US, somewhere in Australia, I guess. But yes, because major projects are from US. So that is the main base for Mu Sigma.
And how old is the company and where is it based?
So basically, it has been, I guess, 11 years because it was founded in 2004. And it has its headquarters in Chicago, and in Bangalore, it is having its office. And Bangalore is the only place where Mu Sigma is having its office, like in the whole of India. So if you are located in any part of India, you will be coming to Bangalore.
Right. Can you tell me something, Avas? How can we see Mu Sigma around?
Basically, first of all, I would like to tell you that this is not a products company, it's a service company. So, you won't be able to see a direct Mu Sigma product or a direct, you won't be able to link yourself directly with the Mu Sigma. But the thing is that the solution which we provide to the client, like for suppose, if you take about a particular cafe, then what should be the number of like coffee they should keep in mind, that depending on the number of customers, or if they are opening a cafe, what location it should be and what should be nearby those cafes, what is the customer density in that particular thing. So we help our clients in all those patterns. So if you enter a particular, we make sure that okay, if you are entering a particular place, there is no out of stock sort of thing for you, that okay, something is not available, this is not there. So for our clients, we make sure that they are able to serve their customers. Indirectly, we serve you, like to have a provide you a better customer experience, and indirectly helping our clients to do the same. So that's how we relate. You can relate Mu Sigma to your daily life.
How is Mu Sigma? First of all, are there any competitors that Mu Sigma has in India?
So basically, if again talking about data analysis, there might be you can list down a few companies, but talking about the data science and the end-to-end approach we have and the way we think, I don't think any company has progressed in this sector the way Mu Sigma has done in the past 11 years. So I don't think, like, in data science we have, like, someone we can say a very good competitor at the same level. According to me, I'm not that sure in this particular sector right now, but according to me, I've not heard another name who has done a lot of job in data science. Data science is something that is gaining momentum, and there's this big data thing also. Nowadays, we see that every company is opening this big data thing, and you find a big data company in each and every, like, tech park or something, that there will be two or three big data companies. But there is a difference in approach and everything. Like, right now, I think that this is the difference.
So, what are the technologies that your company is working on?
So, as we said, as I already mentioned, that it's an end-to-end process. So, we work on from understanding the problem to creating hypotheses. Like, hypothesis is something that we think that might lead to the problem, but it might not be true, because that's why it's a hypothesis. Yes. So creating hypothesis, then pitching that to the client. If the client is interested, they give us data, then we do the analysis, we try to prove our hypothesis, then we make a final presentation of how changes a client can make so that it can benefit their company. So like, it's from understanding the problem to providing the solution the whole way. So now there's a lot of products which Musicma manufactures themselves. Like they have a R&D department for themselves. So like initial phases, we work on only those products. We create the tech and an MS Office is anyways necessary. For analytics, we focus on, I think SQL is a very basic thing. You know, if you have a good idea of SQL, I think it would be very beneficial for you when you start with this data analytics. So other softwares like SAS, R, Pig, Hive, so these are all good softwares. Basic difference is sometimes regarding the speed or the data, the size of data which they can handle, because we sometimes get Excel sheets, like generally Excel sheets might be somewhere around 50 to 100 KB. We sometimes get Excel sheets that are of 2 GB and those are the unstructured data. So like again it depends like what is the amount of data, what is the size of data you are having, according to that you select the software. Yeah, it's, you know, basically deals with all those software services.
Extent of the exposure that is given to you at Musicma outside of your normal work?
So it's like at least for table tennis players and football players, I would say, because Dheeraj like those games, the founder. So he has those TT tables placed in cafeteria. So and that's why Musicma has a long working hours, I think. Because we enjoy, really enjoy that particular thing sometimes. So and on the other half, there are certain clubs like there are a lot of clubs like environment clubs, like photography club, dance club. I'm a part of dance club. So we generally have events every two months. Yeah, sometimes we perform in the malls, sometimes perform for the company, just to like refresh the crowd which is working around us. Then other than that, Musicma celebrates those festivals like really in a very good manner. Like last time in it was the Garba and Dandiya, so they kept this Garba and Dandiya night. And on all festivals, we have to wear this ethnic wears. And Musicma has its own day, like two or three events in the entire year. Like one is the expose, so where we are like distributed into groups, we solve a particular problem on pen and paper. Then again after that, we have a dinner and then DJ night. Other events are like pajama parties. So in that particular thing, there is a general discussion about how Musicma is doing, what's its market value, what are the things they are dealing with. So basically it's a pajama party because all the employees come in pajamas and they stay for the whole night. They enjoy the pizzas and cold drinks there out there. So yeah, there are such sorts of events that go on general basis. Then they conduct these quizzes every week. Then learning sessions are there. So yeah, it's a bit interesting other than that.
Does Musicma take you out on like outing trips?
Yeah, so this is a really good thing. I mean, every 2 months we have a team outing. So like the company pays a sort of amount for each and every employee if you're going out. So you can decide the place. It might be anything, it might be a resort or just a dinner sort of something like barbecue or something. Like once we went to a Govantara resort. So it was a one-day experience, but it was really good. Again, it depends on your team you are allocated to. Like you might even end up landing to Goa or Coorg. That depends on your manager or your planning team. So yeah, there are outings. There are frequent outings.
How's the food? How's the food at Musicma?
So it's not the thing that actually it's not only the cafeteria the Musicma provides. Like there are a lot of things in around also. There is a other food court in within that particular premises and all those things. But the thing is that they provide you with a lot of variety. Like the food might range from South Indian to North Indian, except non-vegetarians.
And you said you were mentioning something about free breakfast.
Yeah. So yeah, if those who feared about Musicma working hours and all those things. Like it's not that particular thing. You can easily end up your work. Like if you're very efficient, you can end up your work and you can leave office early also. And right now there is an initiative taken about free breakfast things. Like earlier also it was there that if you're staying in the office after 8 or 8:30, then you get a free dinner. You can reimburse your money. And now they have started with this free breakfast strategy.
About the general culture, like the relationship inside the team, the relationship with the boss, how the pressure that is, you know, you.
I would like to tell you one thing, in Mu Sigma, the people who join Mu Sigma after being in some other company, they never leave Mu Sigma. I mean, till prior, for all the persons whom I have met till now, because they say that the work life, the environment which is here, even for me, I've been for 5 months, and there's nothing like someone is your boss, or you have to report someone, or you need to fear someone. You never get that particular feeling, because everyone is on the same page. You'll be contributing to your project in a similar manner. Sometimes it turns out that you give more content to the project than your manager. It might happen. That all depends, because as I told you, that how well were you able to relate yourself to that problem, and how well were you able to solve it. So it all depends on your field of interest or your talent. So it's nothing like bossy sort of environment in Mu Sigma. You can enjoy your work, you can interact freely with your manager regarding all the aspects. It need not be only related to work. So yeah, in that particular thing, I guess it has the best working environment, according to me.